Students, I am Kamaljit Sharma, PGT Accountancy, teaching Accountancy in Cambridge International School, Dasua. Students, in this time of crisis, Cambridge International School has taken an initiative to start e-classes to help the students at home. So, stay home, stay safe, and study regularly. Dear students, now we will start chapter number 4. That is accounting for partnership firm, admission of a partner. In this chapter, we will cover the topics like calculation of new profit sharing ratio, calculation of sacrificing ratio, treatment of goodwill, revaluation of assets and reassessment of liabilities, preparation of partner's capital account and balance sheet, and the last topic is adjustment of capital. Today's topic is treatment of goodwill. As per accounting standard 26, that is the accounting standard for intangible assets, goodwill should be accounted in the books only when any money or money worth is paid for it. Thus, in case of admission or retirement or death of a partner or change in profit sharing ratio among partner, goodwill is not accounted in the books of the firm because consideration in money or money's worth is not paid for it. It should be adjusted through partner's capital account, and if goodwill is accounted, that is raised, it should be written off immediately. Students, at the time of admission of a partner, it is but obvious that when a new partner comes into a business, comes into a partnership firm, due to the admission of that new partner, the old partners must sacrifice their profit share in the favor of the incoming partner. Obviously, the new partner or the incoming partner must compensate the old partners for their sacrifice of profit share. That amount of compensation which is paid by the incoming partner to the old partners for their sacrifice of profit share is called goodwill, or we can say it premium for goodwill. This premium for goodwill will be transferred to sacrificing partners only in their capital accounts in case of fluctuating capital and in current accounts in case of fixed capitals in their sacrificing ratio. There may be different cases, different situations in which we have to treat the goodwill. Start with first case, when a new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash or in the form of check and paid privately to old partners. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share in future profits. C paid rupees 2000 privately to A and B as a share of premium. Generalize. So, students, it is very much clearly in the question that the incoming partner, the new partner, brings his share of goodwill in the form of cash, rupees 2000, but paid privately to A and B. Privately means that is outside the business. So when this is clearly mentioned in the question that the amount of premium brought in by the new partner is paid privately to the sacrificing partners, then there will be no journal entry into the business. There will be no recording in the books of the firm. Now the next case is when new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash or by check and the same amount is retained in the business. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share in future profits. C paid rupees 20,000 as capital and rupees 4,000 as a share of premium, which is to be retained in the business. Journalize. As per the question, C, that is the new partner, brings rupees 20,000 as his capital and 4,000 as his premium for goodwill, and there is no information that the amount is brought in the form of cash or by check. So we can write cash account debit, or we can also write bank account debited. So the journal entry would be cash account debit or bank account debit to C's capital account to premium for goodwill account. The total amount brought in by C is rupees 24,000, and out of which 24,000, 20,000 is the capital and 4,000 is the share of goodwill. This share of goodwill of rupees 4,000 will be transferred to old partners in their capital or current account, as the case may be, in their sacrificing ratio. In this question, the sacrificing ratio is 3:2 that we have to calculate in the working notes. So when we divide the 4,000 in sacrificing ratio, the amount would be 2,400 and 1,600. There is a note written over here that in case of fixed capital, amount must be transferred to current account. This should be noted. Coming to the next case, when the new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash or by check and the full amount is withdrawn by sacrificing partner. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share in future profits. C paid rupees 20,000 as capital and 4,000 as his share of premium. A and B withdrew the amount of premium. Journalize. As per the question, in this case, the sacrificing partners or the old partners withdrew the amount of goodwill which is brought in by the incoming partner. It is clearly mentioned in the question that the amount of premium is withdrawn by A and B. So first two entries will remain the same as in the previous case, like cash or bank account debited to C's capital account to premium for goodwill account, the same amount 24,000, C's capital is 20,000 and premium for goodwill is 4,000. The amount of premium, which is rupees 4,000, will be transferred to the sacrificing partners in their sacrificing ratio. So entry would be premium for goodwill account debit to A's capital account or the current account in case of fixed capitals, to B's capital account or the current account. The amount would be transferred in their sacrificing ratio, that is 3:2. The amount would be 2,400 and 1,600. Now, first two entries are same as in the previous case, when the new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash and the same amount is retained in the business. But in the third entry, in this question, it is clearly mentioned that the amount of goodwill brought in by the new partner is withdrawn by the sacrificing partners. So third entry is for withdrawing the amount out of the business. The entry would be A's capital or current account debited, B's capital or current account debited to cash or bank account. We can write cash, we can write bank, and in the case is when the new partner brings his share of goodwill in cash or by check and only a part of full amount is withdrawn by sacrificing partner. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share in future profits. C paid rupees 20,000 as capital and rupees 4,000 as his share of premium. A and B withdrew half of the amount of premium. Generalize. Students, in this question, it is clearly mentioned that only the half of the amount of the premium is withdrawn by the partners. So be careful while recording the journal entries. So in the question, it is clearly mentioned that half of the amount of the goodwill is withdrawn by the partner. All the journal entries are as same as the previous question. But in the last entry, the amount of goodwill which is withdrawn by the partner is half of the amount which is already credited to them in the second entry. So be careful and read the question properly while answering it. Next case is when old partners withdrew the amount of goodwill and goodwill already appears in the books of the firm. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share in future profits. C paid rupees 20,000 as capital and only rupees 4,000 as a share of goodwill of premium. A and B withdrew half of the amount of premium But goodwill already appears in the books of the firm at ₹10,000. Generalize. So students, the question is just same as the previous question, except one transaction. In this question, it is clearly mentioned that goodwill already appears in the books of the firm at ₹10,000. So as per the accounting standard 26, which we have read earlier, according to that accounting standard, goodwill will not be recorded in the books of the firm until money or money worth is paid for it. So first of all, we will write off the goodwill which is existing in the books of the firm while answering it. So students, while answering this question, we will write, first of all, we will write off the existing goodwill in old partners capital account in their old ratio. The first journal entry would be A's capital account debit, B's capital account debit to goodwill account. The amount would be 6,000, 4,000, which is divided in their old profit sharing ratio. After writing off the goodwill, we will record the next transaction, which is related to the incoming partner, that is C. So C brings ₹20,000 as capital and 4,000 as premium. So entry would be cash account debit to C's capital account to premium for goodwill account. Total cash would be 24,000, capital 20,000 and premium for goodwill 4,000. And this premium for goodwill will be transferred to sacrificing partners in their sacrificing ratio. And as mentioned in the question that half of the amount of goodwill is withdrawn by the partners, we will record the journal entry for this transaction also. A's capital account debit, B's capital account debit to cash account is the journal entry for this transaction, which is half of the amount of the goodwill is withdrawn by the partners. So the next case is when the new partner brings his share of goodwill and the same amount is retained in the business. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 4:1. They admitted C for 1/3 share in future profits. It was agreed that A and B would share future profits equally. C paid ₹60,000 as capital and 15,000 as a share of premium of goodwill, which is to be retained in the business, generalize. So students, in the first instance, this example is looks like same as example number 2 of this topic, which says that the new partner brings capital as well as share of premium of goodwill and the same amount is retained in the business. But there is a little bit difference in this example, in this question, in this case. So be careful while answering these type of questions. In this question, at the time of admission of a new partner, one of the old partner also gains, his profit share also rises, his profit share also increases. So in this question, we have seen that B, who is an old partner, also gains at the time of admission of C. C brings ₹60,000 as capital and 15,000 as premium of goodwill, which we have recorded in the first journal entry, that is cash account debit to C's capital account to premium for goodwill account. But at the time of calculation of sacrificing ratio, we come to know about the gain of the B. B is also gaining. The profit share of the B also rises. In this question, only A is sacrificing. A is alone sacrificing his profit share in the favor of new partner, as well as also sacrifice some part of his profit share to the existing partner B. So while answering these type of questions, we must calculate the amount of compensation which is payable by the gaining partner to the sacrificing partners. In this question, we have calculated this amount at ₹6,000, which is paid by the B to A. So the second journal entry would be premium for goodwill account debit, B's capital or current account debit to A's capital account or current account. So the next case is when the new partner brings only a part of his share of goodwill. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share in future profits. C paid ₹20,000 as goodwill out of his share of ₹24,000. no goodwill account appears in the books of the firm journalized. So students, in this question, the total amount of premium which C must bring is rupees 24,000, but he is not able to bring total rupees 24,000. He is bringing only rupees 20,000 out of this 24,000. So we will record the journal entries accordingly. As it is mentioned in the question that C is not able to bring the total amount of the premium of goodwill. So out of 24,000, he is bringing only rupees 20,000. So we will record only 20,000 as his premium for goodwill in the first entry, cash account debit to premium for goodwill. Then after the first entry, this amount of rupees 20,000 will be transferred to sacrificing partners in their sacrificing ratio, along with the amount of deficiency which we will be getting by debiting C's capital or C's current account. So the journal entry would be premium for goodwill account debit, C's capital or current account debit to A's capital account or current account, to B's capital account or current account in their sacrificing ratio. Write this note clearly that in case of deficiency of the amount of premium for goodwill, the new partner's capital or current account will be debited. The next case is when the new partner brings his share of goodwill in kind. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admit C for 1/4 share in future profits. C contributed the following assets towards his capital and his share of goodwill, which includes stock worth rupees 40,000, debtors 60,000, land 1 lakh, plant and machinery rupees 60,000. On the date of admission of C, the goodwill of the firm was valued at rupees 40,000. Journalize. So students, in these type of questions where the new partner brings his share of capital and goodwill in the form of kind, we will debit all the assets which the new partner brings towards his share of capital and premium for goodwill. As per the rule of real accounts, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. All the assets must be debited. So stock account debited 40,000, debtors account debited 60,000, land account debited 1 lakh, plant and machinery account debit 60,000, to C's capital account 2,50,000, to premium for goodwill 10,000. This premium for goodwill is calculated by multiplying the profit share of new partner with the total goodwill of rupees 40,000. Total goodwill of the firm is given in the question at rupees 40,000 and C's profit share is 1/4. So 40,000 into 1/4 is equals to 10,000. If 10,000 is the amount of premium for goodwill, the remaining amount will be calculated as capital of the incoming partner. After that, the premium for goodwill will be transferred to old partners, or you can say sacrificing partners, in their sacrificing ratio. The next case is when the new partner does not bring his share of goodwill. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. They admitted C for 1/4 share. C paid rupees 20,000 as capital, but not able to bring his share of goodwill of rupees 4,000. No goodwill account appears in the books of the firm journalize. So in this question, the new partner is not able to bring any amount for his share of goodwill, for premium for goodwill. So in these type of questions, we will record the amount of capital which is brought by incoming partner by passing the journal entry cash account debited to C's capital account. Since C is not able to bring any amount for his goodwill, we will debit C's capital or current account, and the amount of premium which is 4,000 in this question will be transferred to sacrificing partners in their sacrificing ratio. Write this note very clearly that when the new partner is not able to bring any cash or goodwill, his capital or current account will be debited accordingly. So this is the last case of this topic, that is hidden goodwill. For example, A and B are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 3:2. Their capitals were rupees 40,000 and 30,000 respectively. They admitted C as a new partner for 1/5 share in profits. C brought 30,000 as his capital. Calculate the value of goodwill of the firm and record necessary journal entries on C's admission. So students, in these type of questions, the value of goodwill is not given, but we have asked to calculate the amount of goodwill and also record the journal entries related to this goodwill. Students, first of all, we will calculate the amount of goodwill of the firm. So see, in the working notes we have calculated the goodwill. So steps for calculating the goodwill is, first of all, we have to calculate the total capital of the new firm. In this question, the capital of C is rupees 30,000, which is given in the question, and the profit share of C is 1/5. After multiplying the reciprocal of profit share of C with the capital brought in by C, we will get total capital of the new firm, which comes to 1,50,000. Now we have to calculate the existing capital of the firm. Firm includes A, B and C, the new partner. A's capital 40,000, B's capital 30,000, and capital brought in by C is 30,000, and the total existing capital of the firm is rupees 1 lakh. Now we have calculated total capital of the new firm is 1,50,000 and existing capital is 1 lakh rupees. So the difference between the total capital of the new firm and the existing capital of the partners, including the capital of new partner, is the goodwill of the firm, total goodwill of the firm, which comes to 50,000 in this question. And C's share of goodwill is 1/5 of 50,000, which is rupees 10,000. So 10,000 is the amount of goodwill which C has to bring, but he is not able to bring this amount. In this question, there is no information that the C brings his share of goodwill in cash. Since there is no information, we assume that he is not able to bring the amount of goodwill. We will record the entries like this. First entry, cash account debit to C's capital account 30,000. C's capital account or the current account debited to A's capital or current account to B's capital or current account. This second entry is the amount of goodwill which is to be transferred to sacrificing partners in their sacrificing ratio. So students, we have completed the topic treatment of goodwill. Now it is homework time. So please try to solve all the questions related to the topic treatment of goodwill from chapter number 5, admission of a new partner, from your book Double Entry Bookkeeping by T.S. Grewal, volume 1. These questions are given at the end of every chapter as exercise questions. And also try to solve all the questions related to this topic from NCERT. And please give special attention to the MCQs. Read all the MCQs very carefully and note it down in your homework notebook. And if there is any query or you have any doubt, you can call me personally at my phone number which you are having. So students, stay home, stay safe, but study regularly. Thank you very much.